So the ancient Chinese people believed in balance and harmony within all relationships. For example, according to Confucian thought, there's a real emphasis and concern for balance and harmony between ancestors and their offspring, between a husband and a wife, between two friends, but even between the ruler and the citizens and humans and nature.
Professor, how would you associate the impact of these beliefs with the ancient Chinese literature?
That's a very good question.
Perhaps you can tell us some stories?
Absolutely.
Balance and harmony. Well, it really reminded me of those literati throughout the Chinese history.
Tai居东篱下，悠然见南山。敢问小友，这附近可有酒家？有啊，西华村的酒在我们这儿可是一绝。多谢。听着这钟声，我的心都静了下来。善哉，洋洋西若江河。 放眼这天下，也只有你才懂我的曲子。可怜无定，何必苦？犹是春归梦。
且饮了这杯，此去经年呐。若能赏遍这大好河山，我此生无憾。
青青子衿，悠悠我心。嗯，先生，今晚上我一定能把它背会。真想留不住这春天。问君能有几多愁，恰似一江春水向东流。昨夜雨疏风骤。
浓水不消残酒，再敬你一杯吧。这西出阳关，可再无故人了。
燕雀安知鸿鹄之志？
夜阑卧听，风吹雨，铁马冰河，入梦来。 不以物喜，不以己悲。居庙堂之高，则忧其民；处江湖之远，则忧其君。先帝创业未半而中道崩殂，尽天下三分。蓦然回首。 那人却在灯火阑珊处。
野马也，尘埃也。
心物之于兮相吹
夜欢离合月有阴晴圆缺
不见武陵豪杰墓浮夸无求出作天
人生在世不称意罢了干了这杯哈
哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈
哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈
哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈
Those were some fascinating stories.
Now I am interested in reading more Chinese literature. Hey, Dynasty, since you are an international student, do you got any suggestions?
Okay. To be honest, I don't know where to start.
Ah, you gotta think about it because there are so many good ones, right?
Exactly. That is my point. And I think I should be proud of that.
Yeah, definitely.
Everyone should be proud of their cultures.
And we gotta respect and appreciate all the others
too. I love that.
What a great conversation.
Hey, let's hang out for dinner together.